Apple's WWDC is right around the corner, and by right around the corner, I mean in 2 months. Nonetheless, Apple will be showing off their newest updates for their products, like iOS 19, watchOS, and most importantly, VisionOS 3. Today, I just want to talk about what I think we'll be seeing in the next VisionOS update. And if you think I'm totally wrong, well, you can just yell at me in the comments, I don't know. First things first, new virtual environments. It's been 8 months since we've got a new one to hang around in and watch movies in. And while the ones that we already have are beautiful, it'd be nice to explore some new places. I'm thinking maybe Apple Park, the Grand Canyon, a spaceship, the Earth's core. Any one of these options would be great in my opinion. All of the environments Apple has made are very high quality and have a ton of attention to detail to them, so I'm looking forward to the next ones. Next up, there should be a pass-through camera API for developers. This past month, Meta gave developers access to the cameras on the Quest so that they can create some cool mixed reality experiences, like object recognition or overlays on tracked items. I think this would be great for the Vision Pro since it has many high-resolution cameras and would open the door to a ton of different experiences. A timer always hovering over a stove or a virtual poster sticking to a wall, for instance. One feature that's sorely needed is native VisionOS apps for Apple apps that don't have them yet. What I mean by that is that the reminders, clock, Pages, and Books app are their iPadOS versions for some reason, meaning that they're stuck in the iPad aspect ratio and the UI is boring compared to the Photos or Safari app, which are native VisionOS apps. In terms of features that I highly doubt will be coming out, but I would still want to speak into the universe, both a 2D to 3D video feature and VR-related improvements would be sick. The Vision Pro already has an incredible 2D to 3D image conversion feature using AI in the Photos app, but I'd love it if they added video support too. In terms of VR-related improvements, currently, VR games on this headset are bound to a 3x3 meter boundary, and if you go outside of that zone, it makes the ground transparent. A Meta Quest-like boundary system that you can set up on your own would make VR and PC VR a better experience on this headset. And finally, the greatest feature that Apple could possibly add to VisionOS 3, automatically subscribing all Vision Pro owners to my channel. Anyways, that's all for today, but make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!